I also want to take this opportunity, Mr. Speaker, to say that this feeling of betrayal runs very, very deep in my riding. I was at a rally on Saturday held by truckers who have been laid off, given notice summarily that they would no longer be given entry into the port. And let me tell you, Mr. Speaker, some of these truckers have got experience going over 20, 24, 28 years of driving into that port. They brought their families, they brought their children, and it was heartbreaking because they cannot understand, because only last year they signed a deal. They signed a deal, but they didn't realize, and they weren't told at the time, that that deal had some hidden components and some other output that would lead to a massive number of layoffs of people who are trying to make a living. And that, Mr. Speaker, is unconscionable. And Mr. Speaker, if you had been there and seen those little children, and if you had talked to the men who were the drivers or their wives, you would have heard their stories of betrayal. They feel betrayed by the federal government, they feel betrayed by the provincial government. And while they treat this like a hot potato being passed from one level of government to the other, to the port, what they're saying is, we want a solution. So here today, I'll also appeal to the minister to intervene here, because I believe the federal government does have a role. It's a port issue. We've got massive unemployment happening all around us, and we need to address these. And we need to have some answers for the drivers who've given good, loyal service, and there is no transparency. You go to work and you get a letter to say your license ends on Monday. That's it. Don't turn up for work. That's just not good enough.